Today I want to take a quick look at DaVinci Resolve for free versus the studio version from a VFX perspective. So let's see how much you can do for free with Resolve, see which features actually require an upgrade and under which circumstances you may be able to work around it if upgrading to the studio license is currently not in your financial scope. So this video is primarily for students, for hobbyists, for educators, anybody who has to think about budget on that level. If you are a full-time professional, usually the studio version is a no-brainer. You probably have it already. I don't think you need this video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. And for everyone else, let's take a more detailed look. Good news first, a lot works in the free version. So you might know from editing and color grading, all the basic tools are in the free version. Usually once you go more towards modern AI powered effects, like for editing, for example, a speed warp in the color page, magic mask and those things, this is usually when you start to look towards the studio license. Also, there are some GPU accelerations, some limits for really, really high resolution that might also trigger the studio license. Now let's look from a Fusion perspective. If you are primarily interested in motion graphics, no problem. Everything there essentially works with the free version. All the Fusion title templates, lower thirds, call out titles, that kind of stuff, you can do pretty much all of it in the free version. From a VFX compositing perspective, I just want to talk about like five main points that I think may trigger the upgrade. And depending on what specifically you're doing right now and in what context and so on, you can then better understand how well you can work around them or if you actually want to go towards the studio license. All right, so let's look at those studio features in no particular order, starting with the Magic Mask. The Magic Mask is an AI-powered rotoscoping solution in DaVinci Resolve. I use it a lot for preview purposes, for some additional masks in green screen keying, especially whenever you need like a loose mask, like a loose garbage mask, then I tend to use it. I don't yet use it that much. If you really need 100% precise masking, often you have to go back to rotoscoping. So the manual workflow rotoscoping is of course possible. It's also possible there are third-party rotoscoping applications. It is possible to get your mask from another service and then import it. It's also possible to get your mask from one computer and share it with students or with another computer if you have multiple machines and only one studio license. Second point, tracking. Here we have two things that are not possible in the free version. The new IntelliTrack AI-powered point tracker isn't available. However, keep in mind, for a very long time, we have worked without it and just had the regular point tracker. It's sometimes a bit less stable. It sometimes needs more tweaking. However, it's still there and it has worked for decades. So now we have something better, but if you don't have that, you can still do most of the stuff anyways. 3D camera tracking, we don't have an easy workaround. So essentially, when you do 3D camera tracking, the tracking itself requires the studio license. Once the track is completed, you can use the camera that you get from the track and can use that in a non-studio version as well. So that's often a workaround for universities if not everyone has the studio license. There are third-party applications that can do 3D camera tracking. Again, most of those are quite pricey. Blender has some option for the 3D camera tracking. I think it's not that advanced from well, last time I checked, although that's been some time ago. But anyhow, if you have another application, you can export the camera, for example, as an FBX mesh or as a Maya camera file or something, whatever is supported, and then import it into DaVinci Resolve. Next point, using Fusion Studio. This may or may not be relevant to you. So for me, I sometimes work on pure VFX shots where I get like 100 frames. I need to do something on those 100 frames and send them back. In those cases, I have no need for Resolve. I don't need all the timeline, media pool, database stuff, and so on. I just need Fusion and nothing else. And in this case, I work in Fusion Studio. It's a bit more lightweight. It starts faster. You have a render queue for remote rendering and so on. It just has a bit less overhead and less thinking around it if all you do is one VFX shot. May also be interesting for CG artists who just have one render sequence to work on or a couple of render sequences, then you don't need all of this. Fusion Studio comes automatically if you have the Resolve Studio license, so you get two license activations. You can use one for Resolve, one for Fusion Studio, or you can use them on two machines, however you want to split that, or if you have a license dongle, you can use that as well, and it works for Resolve and for Fusion Studio. Number four, advanced ResolveFX and OpenFX. So here we are talking about the different ResolveFX plugins that are not available, or if you need third-party plugins, you need the studio license in order to run them. There are two which for me are quite important. So some form of lens blur, lens effects. There is a lens blur in Fusion Studio. It's a bit slower. The Resolve one tends to be a bit faster in my experience. If I need something more advanced, like for depth of field, I tend to use the Frischluft lens scare. So this is an external plugin which doesn't work in the free version. I also sometimes go to Mocha Pro, which again is an OpenFX effect. So those are the things if you want to need to integrate with other third-party commercial plugins, you need it. And then among the ResolveFX or external effects, there is one which I want to point out particularly. Maybe let's make it number five on this arbitrary list. That is temporal noise reduction. That's really critical for many VFX workflows. So very often we want to reduce noise or remove the noise, then do our compositing tasks, manipulate, paint on the image, whatever, and then bring noise back on top. That usually requires temporal noise reduction. You can use the ResolveFX from the color page in DaVinci Resolve. If you have the studio license, then you have a temporal noise reduction. Personally, I also use Neat Video, especially in Fusion Studio, where I don't have the ResolveFX. I haven't done a side-by-side comparison. Some people swear that Neat Video is better. I don't know. I'm just used to it, and it does the job for me. If you are stuck with the free version and you can't get a denoised clip from somewhere else, then your only option is the spatial noise reduction. Fusion does have a free one there. However, spatial noise reduction is pretty similar to blurring the image, and that's usually not what you want, unless you have like AI-powered spatial noise reduction, but that's again different and again requires the studio license. So basically there isn't really much you can do. You can do a tiny bit of blur, tiny bit of spatial noise reduction if you can get away with it. In some cases you can get away without denoise or add some artificial noise on top to kind of cover things up or add it on the compositing elements alone and try to match it somehow. But yeah, your options are simply limited, and in more advanced and professional workflows, you certainly need a temporal noise reduction. And that's the point where you simply need the studio license at that point. Okay, that was my overview. I hope it gives you a bit of an understanding where the limits are, and you can choose yourself how long you can work with those limits and when you need it. If you need to buy a studio license, of course, keep in mind that Blackmagic Design often bundles it with certain hardware. So just in case you or your company or university already has Blackmagic Design hardware or is thinking about it, just check on the website which one is bundled with the studio license. So I think for editing, the speed editor and editor keyboard are bundled with it, the mini and advanced grading panels, and many of the cameras. So just in case that's relevant for you, just check, you might already get a license or have one. And this was it for today's more general overview. My next video will again be a Fusion technical tutorial. So see you then. Cheers.